Shuja'ah. His infirm, Zahiruddin, and Gulshir, and I think all of us, his parents, and all of the friends all together, who are before me, and I know so many personally, but new generation is always in the process of coming together to the generation of ours. Because I was telling Mr. Hussain, I could recall today when my first novel was the same day I was, I think, maybe elder than him. I was 18, 19 years old, boy at the time, when my first novel got inaugurated at that very time. It was Jhoote Kinare, then Zakhmon Ki Salgara, and then the series of the novels, etc. I started writing because I could find the only way where you, whatever emotions you have in your mind, whatever you can imagine, is to your pen. Pen is the biggest instrument, and today it is a laptop. If it was a pen at the time, today it is a laptop. Through which you can really imagine. You can imagine sometimes history of. You can sometimes imagine that your relationship with your mama, papa of this age. Then the emotional romanticism comes, and then with your new generation you start relating. Then there's relation with the society. Then trying to describe the society. In which society you are. And from this society, what you are going to present to the world. And today also I find this very small function, but the most important and most pivotal, most fundamental. Because a boy from Kashmir is talking about Adolf Hitler. A boy from Kashmir is talking and imagining, making eye contact with the sweeping through the cursory looks through chapter 5 of his novel. You have to be released, but I just saw the chapter 5. And in chapter 5, when last moment of the Hitler, very emotional one, when he is marrying the Eva, and he are married. And that's imagination. Because there are so many imaginations about the Hitler, about the last moments of Hitler. If you peek through the Google just now, you will find the grave of Hitler in Kashmir. You can see it just now. It was published in the Star of London that his last repentance came. He was imported. He was brought to Kashmir to Maharaja of that time, Hari Singh. He made the hideout in the Rosebud, and Rosebud was at that time declared the Jesus shrine. Till that, there is no book available in Kashmir when you could find it's a Jesus grave, because there is no history of having the Jesus grave. But something happened abruptly. Some mysterious guest disappeared from the Germany, and that was also by Graham. It was William Graham has written recently last year the history about the last days of the Hitler. He's writing that he never committed suicide at all. He was taken to one of the princely secret states. And you know, the closest man was Subhash Chandra Bose from India, who was close to Adolf Hitler, who has met Adolf Hitler. And that he has Azad Hind Fauj. And the active member was Maharaja Hari Singh as well. So Maharaja Hari Singh was trying to keep the balance with Germans also, with the British forces also on one side. Sometimes he was very close to Jinnah, sometimes he was very close to Gandhi. So Maharaja Hari Singh played so many games at the time, because he was autocrat, he was not a democrat. So if he has come, I call it if, because it is also, because you should definitely find in the Google grave of Hitler. You'll decided as a son, people have come also there and made him safe paper on that. If he has come, so he has accepted the supremacy of our spirituality. He has made the repentance. If he has made the repentance, Hindu also made the repentance at the last moment. So many savage people of the world made a repentance. The Ashoka made the repentance. Ashoka was one of the killers of so many wars. But at the last moment he repented and turned to be the Buddhist. So if it is, so it can be another way of imagining the last moments of the Hitler. Because I recall, before 2 days before the death, Indira Gandhi went to Renzushah and she fell down on the stairs of the Renzushah. And she went to the sadhu, it is in Ishbar. So he went to that sadhu and he told, she told him that, and what happened. He advised him not to leave Kashmir for 10 days. It is a spiritual translation, maybe from his point of view. But she preferred to leave. She couldn't go by his advice. And shawl was given to her by that sadhu. She is delivering the last lecture in Calcutta, telling that I may live or may not live, because she, it was haunting in her mind that I fell down, my fall was on the stairs of the Renzushah, and the same shawl she was wearing, which was given to her as shield, but it could not stop the bullets which was fired by her own security guards to her. So this spirituality also plays a role in so many situations. We had a disappearance of the Moin Muqaddas from the Hazrat Pak. It's a part of history. So many regimes came and so many regimes fell down because of the disappearance of our Moin Muqaddas, which I am a believer of all these crimes. So, so far no such documents have been revealed. This is the era of revelation. This is the era when all these secret documents should be made public. If these documents are available, should be made public so that Hussain-like people, that's why it is reminding my mind. I'm talking this time because this is some different topic I am, absolutely a different topic I am presently discussing today, because you have inspired me. You have inspired me to tell to the regimes of the present time, why should not you reveal the document who has stolen my Moin Muqaddas? A Hussain-like man will write a novel on it, a book on it. Why should not they reveal those secrets? They know it, because I have read one Malik's book. Nasiruddin might be knowing better than me. He's a well-known journalist. Mr. Malik, B.M. Malik, has written a book that I know who stole it. I know. So why should not it be me? So that book started. Why should not this Hitler's documents are more made public? There will be attention. Definitely, people might be feeling, because it is such a name when my friend was giving me a call, then he told me that you have to come on this function. So I told him that I will be coming, but the name itself is a very different name, Hitler. Some people may translate in some other way. A book on a Kashmiri boy is writing a book on the Hitler. My God, Hitler is being eulogized. No, you are not eulogizing him. And it should be kept in record. Hitler cannot be eulogized. An autocrat cannot be eulogized. I cannot eulogize. I was in a know, one of the big functions, there was a big audience. Somebody was praising Hari Singh. I said, I cannot. Because I believe in the democracy. He was an autocrat Maharaj who has plundered my democracy in Kashmir. How can I? I should not. Those anybody who is believing in a majoritarian rule. Adolf Hitler had a new concept. It was a majoritarian rule. That majority is the German. Germans are the superior. A supremacy of German. They have the right to rule. A wrong concept. See, what I have learned from my Rasul Pak sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That everybody is equal. Hazrat Bilal is not a slave. He is my companion. That was the concept given by that there is no superiority or the inferiority in the world in the person. These are the things we have to ponder, and these are the situations where these things should be liberally debated, should be liberally discussed. Why I am talking always of the Sufia? So many asked me a question when I was the Director General, or why I was Additional Divisional Commissioner, DC Patna, or any Director Information, or whatever post I was holding. People like Mr. Nasir Sahib were asking me a question. Why is Renzushah Sahib kya karta hai? Bade Sufi jo usme hota hai ji, unko koi bade kya hai, kya hai, kya hai? So these were so many, my opponents were big. But I was always believing that this is the triumphant ideology that while Hindu, Muslim, Sikhs cannot be discriminated. Have a laptop in one hand and have a Quran Sharif in one hand. Have a Gita in your hand, have a laptop in one hand. Have a Guru Granth Sahib in your hand, have a laptop in one hand. This is the knowledge. Whatever religions give you the knowledge, at least they give you the knowledge. They give you the spirituality. And once they give you the spirituality, Shaykhul Alam emerges. Lovely emerged. I'm so very happy that in present times I was walking towards the Navata and I was really astonished. I was listening that the Grand Army of Navata was chanting the Lalwa. Very happy. I was very happy he was talking Shaykhul Alam. My God, this is the which is required, is a requirement of the present time. So your book. I will, because once this is such a topic, I will continue for hours and hours. And Shuja cannot stop me. But I know she might have to do some other program. So I conclude not only congrats to you, to all of you, that you could understand the importance of it. Particularly, I'm obliged to Shaykhul Rahman, who really called me. I was not expecting this to be such a mature and such a vibrant function. Thank you very much.